Glad to see you made it back in one piece, Velvet.
I'm here on orders from the boss to help you guys out.
We could certainly use it. How are things back in the city?
I came here from Helivis, so I don't know how far the suppression has progressed. But I can tell you that the Abbeys designated the area north of Helivis as a Class 4 administrative zone.
Which means they've pulled their forces out of the area.
What about the people of Mercio?
Everyone got out safe and sound, although they did petition for the extermination of the Lord of Calamity.
Of course.
I say we make this town our new hideout. When else are we ever gonna find a hideout that comes with hot springs?
That's a good idea. We should leave Kamoana and the others here.
Dial, could you stay and help them out?
As if you even had to ask.
Wow, that's surprisingly reliable for you, Dial.
Hey, that hurts! Now get going already! Benwick and the crew are making preparations in Helivis right now. Hey, Rokuro, how'd the showdown with your brother turn out?
I killed him. But I couldn't break Stormhowl.
Is that because Stormhowl was an even stronger sword than Kurigane's?
No. Even with Shigure's full strength behind it, Stormhowl didn't even leave a nick in Kurigane's blade. If I didn't have this sword, I'd be dead now. I think I just couldn't break Stormhowl because I'm still too inexperienced.
But you won the match, didn't you?
Yeah, but only by combining my techniques with Kurogane's craftsmanship.
If that's the case, then as long as you're wielding it, that sword is Stormquell. After all, Kurogane's sword did quell the Godblade's raging storm.
Do you think Kurogane would agree?
Are you kidding? You know how stubborn that guy is. He'd just say he'd forge something even stronger the next time. And that's why I say you shouldn't be satisfied with how you are either, Rokuro.
I know. I'll find even stronger opponents to cut down. By my hand, Kurogane's Stormquell will become even more legendary than Stormhowl ever was.
That's the spirit! Show them what we demons can do!
Grimoire, could we talk?
You sound so serious, like it's the eve of the final battle.
Well, isn't it? Can't you let yourself get caught up in the moment for a change?
Getting caught up in the moment is for young, foolhardy lovers. So, what is it you want to talk about?
I just figured I should drop by since, well, like I said, the final battle with Innominat is coming up and all.
Ugh, you're talking like you're saying your last goodbyes.
It's just that we're up against a lot. Even Miss Mogilu doesn't know what the future holds for us, and she almost always has that stuff figured out.
Whether she has it figured out or not, it is our lot in life to follow our vessels and fight to the very end.
That's what I've always thought, so I just dealt with Miss Mogilu's craziness up till now. But she's never thanked me for it. No, good job, Bianfu. No, I'm glad I'm your vessel. Not even something like, I'll introduce you to a cute girl when it's all over. It'd be nice to hear a little gratitude from her, even just once.
Surely you know she's not the type to do that sort of thing, though, yes?
That's all the more reason to want just one brief glimpse at who she is underneath.
If you're so unhappy, it's not too late to switch back to the Abbey's side and become an informant again.
What's the point in that? I don't know anything they'd want, and they wouldn't have any use for me there.
So you lack confidence in your own abilities?
Miss Mogilu has let me come with her wherever she went, and her talents have gotten us this far. But now that we have to fight Enominat, I'm worried. I don't know what use I can be for her, or if I can keep her safe.
But you'll still go, won't you?
Yeah, of course! Or else my name isn't Norman Brave!
See, you can do this. You've been keeping Mogilu safe this whole time. With all the emotional pain she's been through, she's needed someone as thick-skinned and tenacious as you. She may talk like she doesn't care, but she wouldn't have tracked you down and renewed your pact if she didn't.
When you put it like that, bien! All right, you've convinced me!
That's right. You just trust in old Norman therapist's good advice. It won't steer you wrong.
Wow! I'd have never expected you to actually make a joke like that, Grimoire!
I just thought I'd get caught up in the moment like you wanted.
Thank you. there! Exorcist! Do you know what happened to the Praetor? Lady Teresa? She used to be in charge here. Lady Teresa is the only one who can restore law and order in our town! Please, send a message to the Abbey. Tell them that the citizens of Hellevis are awaiting her return. Even if the Lord of Calamity herself were to attack, I won't budge until Lady Teresa returns to us!
What will refusing to move accomplish?
If my life is in danger, I know Lady Teresa will come to save me! Her, in that ice-cold glare of hers.
Teresa won't be coming back.
What?
If you really love Teresa, you shouldn't rely on her to protect you. You should become strong enough to protect her.
Whoa, that burning glare of yours. I think I like it.
Wait, what?
Planning evacuation routes. We need to be ready if the Calamity or demons show up in town.
When the Calamity attacked the first time, there was massive confusion. Some children got hurt in all the madness. We're preparing evacuation boats, so that we can all flee out to the sea if anything happens.
It's a good idea, but it will be hard to evacuate the entire town by boat. You'd best prepare a land route, too.
That's a good point. But wouldn't a land route run the risk of being attacked by demons?
Yes. You'll need to guard it as heavily as you do the city gates. It would be best if you could devise a way to prevent demons from intercepting the escape route, but...
Some of the exorcists lost use of their malachim. We can't count on the Abbey's garrison to help us.
I'll send a request for aid to the Abbey. But please, don't give up! Try to think of something!
Of course. There's no way we'll give up. You can't rely on someone else to protect you.
Can you really ask the Abbey for help?
I can send a Sylph-Jay to some of my old friends from when I was still in training. Even if they refuse to trust a traitor like me, they won't ignore the plight of the people here in Hellevis.
Did you hear that Moloch they were doing experiments on finally broke?
Yeah. You mean the one where they were trying to combine multiple smaller Malachim into one giant Moloch? I always figured it was a waste of time.
Turns out it not only looked like a freak, but its shackled mind snapped, leaving the thing feral.
Huh? Guess they'll have to dispose of it.
Yeah. For now, they've moved it out to the Faldi's ruins. They're repurposing it as a test target for a new Moloch art and development.
At least we'll be able to get some valuable data out of it.
Using Malachim for their own ends. Is there no line they won't cross?
I hope you're not thinking of doing anything unnecessary.
Oh? Like what?
Like thinking about bringing mercy to a broken Moloch.
What I think is necessary and what actions I take are for me to decide.
Aizen!
That exorcist said they were using the Moloch to get data on a new Moloch art. If it were complete, they could use it against us. Stopping that wouldn't be a waste of our time, would it?
You think you know just what to say to me, don't you?
I'm just stating the truth.
Just so we're clear, we're not going to rescue it.
No argument here.
Thank you. How long are you going to sit there crying? You can't be a fisherman if you're afraid of some Lord of Calamity.
The demons that wrecked this town are still alive. Who knows when they'll show up again?
How about right now?
Sniveling idiot! Keep whining like that, and this calamity whatever will keep walking all over you!
But what can we do? We can't even defeat a single demon.
That's why we take our boats, catch some fish, and make sure we've got enough food to keep on surviving. Didn't they drill anything into that fool head of yours in school? Ugh. Do I have to knock some sense into you? Get up and get the boat ready!
That is one hot-headed dad.
Too hot for any demons to get near, that's for sure.
I heard that the Lord of Calamity appeared in Mercio. Now the whole town's been captured by demons.
What is the Abbey doing? Why don't exorcists come around here anymore?
The Abbey has abandoned us. If the Calamity shows up here, we're doomed. We either run or give up and drown ourselves in drink. If only Lady Teresa were still here.
Why has it come to this? Curse you, Lord of Calamity, for everything you've done!
You're quite the popular girl. Why not wave to your fans?
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Thank you. worth killing. This...
must be that experimental Moloch.
Why a cow's head?
This is bull! Careful! It's on a rampage!
Time to put a stop to this!
Bovine Moloch? Was that the best the Abbey could think up?
As if robbing our free will wasn't enough. Now they're trying to reshape Molochine.
I'm so sorry, Aizen. What they did here was terrible.
I don't really care about the callous experimentation. If the Molochine participated by their own free will, then sure, that's their choice. But this one had its free will locked away and was used and discarded like a mere tool. That's what I can never forgive. And the Abbey is treating countless Molochine the same way.
Sounds like this has gotten you all fired up. Maybe I'm glad we came here.
Oh, believe me. I've been fired up for a good long time. Ever since I decided how I want to live my life.
Welcome back! I take it you defeated the Legates.
Yes, but that still leaves Enominat and the Shepherd.
Onward ho to the last battle! Oh, I picked up something nice for you. Here.
An apple?
It's a fortune apple. A good luck charm. No real powers, but they're hard to find. Legend has it, they're pretty lucky.
A fortune apple.
But we're the bad guys, aren't we? Maybe what we need is bad luck instead.
I think the Reaper's got that covered.
Aw, that's just mean.
Well, I appreciate the thought. Thanks, Benwick. I love apples.
Just don't eat it.
I couldn't eat it, even if I wanted. Wait a moment. That's right. My power to consume is a part of Enominat. If that's true, then...
What is it?
You want a bite? Delicious fortune apple.
No way! That's a good luck charm!
That it is. One to give you the courage you need to survive.
So, where's our final destination?
The Empyrean's throne.
Sail for Port Sexton.
Aye aye, ma'am. Aye aye, sir.
Just don't eat him. Got it?
I won't. Don't worry.
Hey, Rokuro! I heard about a Class 4 island that sounds damn near perfect for you.
An island that's perfect for me? Do the rivers flow with good drink?
Now that you mention it. But no, different island. I'm talking about you as a swordsman. The demons there all run around the island in suits of armor and helmets and stuff, I hear.
Armored demons are not unusual.
Yeah, but what I heard tell was that all the exorcists who got sent there came back with their swords broken. I don't know if they've got swords too, or if their armor is just that strong, but I reckon your sword will be able to stand up to them.
Well then, I've heard worse ideas.
If you believe the tales, that island used to be a place where swordsmen and knights competed to see who was stronger.
Oh yeah, I know the island you're talking about. Craftsmen from all over gave their finest weapons and armor to the greatest of warriors and made them fight. It was as much a showcase for those wares as it was a contest of strength.
So the demons on that island might come at us wielding fine arms and armor.
I'm certainly up for checking it out. I'm curious to see how good the stuff really is.
After all I've told you, you still want to go? What is wrong with you?
Do you think that with Enominat's power waning, people will be free again?
Well, the pirates are acting like pirates again. May take longer for others, but I think it's happening.
What do you think of traveling around to see for ourselves? I'd like to know what's going on out there.
I'd like to meet the Elemental Empyreans, if I could.
That's not a great idea. They're all in various Earth Pulse points, but where those are is a mystery. They could be very far off.
And they might not view us as allies.
Yep, gods live by their own rules. Our business with Enominat probably doesn't concern them.
You're right.
It might be wise to scope out the situation before our battle. As we go around, we might find out more about what Artorias is up to.
We can do this!
think you're one to talk.
Don't get overconfident.
Oh, stop!
wall here!
So, what was it you needed to say to me alone?
Where's Lafayette?
He wanted to stand watch with me, but I forced him to get some rest. After all this fighting, he needs it.
I owe you. That kid always tries to play the tough guy.
Just like the one who named him.
He's nothing like me. His motivation comes from hope.
Hope.
The wind is nice.
Yes, the world may teem with hardship and sadness, but it's also filled with beauty. The endless ocean, the islands in the south, even the frozen tundra and the mountains that spew fire.
It is. And humans make their home among all that beauty. This is the world that Lafi always yearned to travel. I finally understand what he saw when he sat looking out over the ocean. Eleanor, I have a single favor to ask of you. If anything happens to me, take care of Lafayette.
What? Is something the matter?
The power possessed by the Therians and Innominaut is fundamentally the same. I have a theory. No, theory is too rational. A different part of me, something separate from my hatred, wants me to do something. It wants me to leave this world with hope.
Wait, you don't mean...
Humor me, okay? If the worst happens, I'm counting on you.
I understand. You have my word. I'll look after Lafayette. While I'd love to take advantage of this momentary weakness, I can't. My oath is to obey your orders until my dying breath.
I'd almost forgotten about all that. Good thing I kicked your butt after all. Well, the suppression field is gone.
And in its place, rampaging demons.
We expected that. Thanks for everything.
I only did what I felt like doing. Who needs thanks for that?
Let's go. We have a fight to finish with the Shepherd.
Innominaut's power may have weakened, but I think that'll only cause more of a stir in the cities.
Without the Abbey's exorcists, the people will have a hard time quelling demons.
Are you crying?
I'm simply coming to terms with reality. I've learned to think for myself rather than let others do the thinking for me. It's painful and frightening, and comes with great responsibility. But this is who I am now. It's on me to own up, face my fears, and keep moving forward.
You're a piece of work, but I don't mind having you around.
Yes. I'm not weak like I used to be.
No, you aren't.
You don't have to bear the weight of the world alone, though.
I understand that. I will do only what I can.
You always say that, but then you end up overdoing it, right? If you push yourself to the limit and it's still not enough, there's no shame in relying on others.
Rokuro, thank you so much.
You realize you just thanked a demon, right?
I'm aware of that.
We put all our faith in you because you said you could protect us. We endured all your harsh rules and laws.
So how can you tell us you can't defeat the demons because you can't control Malakim anymore?
We don't understand why we've lost the ability to control our Malakim. But even without my Malak arts, I will fight to my dying breath to protect all of you. So please, calm down.
I'm not listening to anything the Abbey says anymore.
What are you looking at? Yeah, you there. Mean-looking guy. Get over here.
I think I'll pass. Thanks.
Hey, Muscles! Get back here! I'm not through with you!
Please stop. I understand that you're worried and upset, but now isn't the time to be fighting amongst ourselves. Please, let us all stand together. Help us fight off the madness and the demons that threaten our world. And if that's not good enough for you, you can face me instead.
Guess I'm sorry.
That exorcist has some serious backbone.
Aye.
It's you! Mogilu's Debauchery.
It's Menagerie.
I finally get a chance to see the famous Mogilu's Menagerie. I've been waiting forever to meet up with you again.
Meet up with us? Why?
Well, with my bad luck, I've always just missed out on seeing your splendiferous performances. So, well, I made my own menagerie. The Abbey is a mess, and people everywhere are scared. Demons abound, and... well, everyone's so gloomy. So I thought that this is exactly the time when people need something fun and happy to lift their spirits. My troop is still in training, but we're almost ready.
That's wonderful. What do you call yourselves?
I wanted something with power, impact. So behold, we are the Dark Wings.
Dark Wings. Huh.
Hey, what gives? That's a terrible reaction.
You're trying to cheer people up, right? So why dark? And dark wings only make me picture crows. Or bats, maybe.
Really? When I think of the Dark Wings, I think comedy. Maybe I should rethink this. Oh, I got it! We'll be the Dark Smiles!
Sounds like you've got a pretty dark sense of humor. You really want to go with such a dark-hearted name?
Okay, fine. The Dark Magic. No, the Dark Circus! No, that's no good. The darkest hour! The dark...
Maybe you could try losing the dark part.
Good point. All right, then. How about this one? The Peddlers of Joy!
We don't accept solicitations.
Fine. Forget you. I've made my decision. We're Darkwing Menagerie of Comedy, and that's final.
He really went all out. Still, you've got zing, kid. Here's hoping you have many dark years to come. Magikazam!
Thanks! That makes us rivals now, but still, from one entertainer to another, good luck!
About that Magikazam of yours, you only use that spell when you couldn't care less what happens, right?
What this world needs now is a good dose of apathy, am I right?
But here's hoping you have many dark years to come. That's not very nice at all, is it?
Magikazam!
Take a look. delicious produce.
Isn't any everyday
what's a bargain?
I can't get my hands on nectar or a good drink anymore, but thanks to that, I've finally seen the light. I tried drinking lots of different things to help cope with my cravings, and I discovered that a nice cup of tea really does the trick. You can't give kids the heavy stuff, but tea? Kids, adults, the elderly, everyone can enjoy it.
That's a good positive point of view.
I'm thinking about using my life savings to open a tea shop filled with tea from all over the world. Rather than let ourselves get all worked up panicking over the demons, we'd be better off sitting down with a nice cup of relaxing tea.
It'd be wonderful if you sold some tasty pies or cookies there, too.
I know, right? I need to find some baked goods that go well with tea. Maybe I can find a girlfriend while I'm at it.
Well, good luck with that.
Thanks. Speaking of which, are you single?
Sorry, think I'll pass.
Yeah, figured as much.
Another day without a wild penguin sighting. How are things looking at the penguin farm?
Not good. They're still listless. I tried changing their feed, but they barely touched it. With the weather what it is, the sea temperature has gone down. Maybe that has something to do with it.
Maybe so. I've been pulling up different fish around here lately too. And get this, I found a kraken queen in my nets the other day. Normally you only find them in the northern oceans.
Kraken queen?
If this keeps up, Esalt's fishing industry is in dire peril. We've got to do something about this.
Fishermen and penguin farmers. We should all get together and have a meeting to figure out what to do.
By the way, you get smacked about by that kraken queen?
Oh yeah, those long whip-like tentacles did a number on me. I loved every moment of it.
Oh man, lucky! I should take the boat out tomorrow, see if I can catch one.
I still don't get it, but as long as they're having fun.
Have you heard the rumors? People are saying there's a talking penguin around.
I didn't know penguins could talk.
It's true. Three people have already talked with it near the beach at night.
You don't say. We should totally try to capture it. It'd be a great addition to Moggy Lou's menagerie.
Well, this is no light matter here in Isolde.
Local legend has it that when the end times come, a talking penguin will declare judgment upon the sinful. Everyone who's encountered this penguin has been bedridden from the sheer shock of it.
Are you sure it's not just some demon?
It doesn't appear to be, though it does seem to be quite aggressive. It goes after people, attacking them as it yells, "I'm a medical student from Rize Maxia!"
Is that supposed to be its judgment or whatever?
I have no idea, but whatever you do, you'd better not visit the beach at night.
This is some kind of reverse psychology trick, right?
I can't sleep. I think I'm going to head down to the beach and check things out.
I'm with you. Some things just can't be avoided.
You're going to look for that talking penguin, aren't you?
What makes you say that? We're just going on a walk.
Look, Velvet! There's a penguin!
Think it might be the talking one?
Oh, good evening. Lovely weather, isn't it?
It really talked!
I can't believe it. Something I eat can talk?
Huh? Wait, do you guys eat us penguins too?
Why does it matter?
Please, answer my question. It's very important.
I'm sorry, but yes, I eat them.
And I'll happily devour most anything if I have to.
Well then, I suppose you people are just like the others who came before. I can't let you keep doing that!
Oh, and what's a cutesy little penguin like you plan on doing about us, big bad humans?
What the hell are you?
Sorry for deceiving you all, but I can't let you hurt any more penguins!
Turn it! 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 Turn it
Back into a Pengyan. No matter.
Wait, why are you so intent on fighting us when you're outnumbered?
I have to protect my fellow Pengyans from the likes of poachers like you.
Poachers?
We're not poachers, I swear. We just came here to see a talking Pengyan.
Really? But then, why did you guys say you eat Pengyans?
Sorry, I guess we should have explained more clearly. This one will eat anything.
Yeah, sorry about that.
And as for me, the only Pengyan I ever eat is what I buy properly at the market.
We're not good people, but we're not those kinds of villains either.
Oh, well in that case, I should apologize for jumping to conclusions and picking a fight. I just ran into some Pengyan poachers earlier, and I'm afraid I'm a little on edge right now.
Those must be the other people who've spotted you here. They're all sick in bed just from the shock of meeting you. Small fries like them, I bet they'll think twice before they try to poach another animal.
So, what are you then? Some special representative of Pengyan kind?
No, I'm Jude Mathis. I'm a medical student from Riza Maxia.
A medical student? From Rize Maxia?
It's in a different world from yours. Actually, I'm a human just like you all, but somehow I was flung into this dimension, and when I came to, I looked like this.
So, basically, you're a human from another world, but when you came here, it made you turn into a Pengyan?
This story of yours, quite a tale. The whole thing's pretty hard to believe.
It certainly is. However, when I was lost and confused, the Pengyans here were kind to me and took me in as their own. I wanted to repay the favor to them since they've done so much for me.
So you've been protecting them from any poachers who come.
But don't you have bigger things to worry about right now? Looks to me like you're too soft-hearted.
I get that a lot.
Well, we've heard your story. But even if it is true, it doesn't sound like there's anything we can do for you.
Don't worry about me. I'll figure out how to get home on my own, one way or another. The problem is that a friend of mine got sent to this world with me, but I haven't been able to find her. My hunch is that she's also turned into a Pengyan. You haven't heard of any other talking Pengyans, have you?
Can't say I have. Sorry.
Oh, okay.
What kind of person is this friend of yours? Maybe we'll run into her later.
Her name is Mila. She has pretty red eyes and long golden hair. She carries herself with dignity and possesses a commanding presence. What else? Oh, and one of her quirks is that whenever she sees something tasty, she drools.
That's an interesting quirk.
You mean she actually drools?
Also, she's known as the Lord of Spirits because she's accompanied by four summon spirits with command over the elements.
Ooh, Lord of Spirits. How royal sounding.
Got it. If we hear anything, we'll let you know.
It may be hard, but try to keep your spirits up, Jude.
Thank you all so much. I hope you guys get a lead on Mila.
You care about her even more than yourself.
Well, how do I put it? She's just a really special person to me, I guess.
Fair enough.
Pengyan. I didn't dream that up, right?
No, that Pengyan was very real. Or rather, it seems to actually be a human named Jude.
He said he came from another world. No matter how much we see, life is still full of mysteries, isn't it?
He's got guts, I'll give him that. It'd be nice if we could help him somehow.
He's kind to Pengyans, too.
If he was telling the truth, that would make him a castaway from another dimension. We seafarers always help out anyone who's adrift.
Personally, I'm curious about this Mila girl, the Lord of Spirits. She might have a connection to the Four Empyreans, or even Enominat himself.
Seems unlikely, but I suppose anything's possible. Just in case, I'll keep everything Jude the Pengyan told us in mind.
Haria Village, getting wiped out by demon blight. Really makes you think, doesn't it? Like, if they had abandoned their faith in Amanoch and moved to Ysolt, they might have been saved.
I'm glad they didn't come here. They deserved it. It's their punishment for heresy.
How could you? No one deserves that fate.
But didn't that priestess and her daughter turn first? That's what caused it to spread. But look at us here in Ysolt. Not a single case of demon blight. That's the only possible explanation. They were crazy to resist the Abbey.
Shame on you. Don't speak ill of the dead. No one wants to become a demon. I had a friend in Haria. She was a good person. Whether she believed in Amanoch or Enominat, she was a person just like us. Our islands were her home.
Perhaps I have no right to say anything here, but please, don't ever lose that kind heart of yours. That's the best way you can honor the memory of Haria's people.
I won't. I'll go there soon with an offering of flowers.
Scout ships.
cup's really getting filled out now.
You seem really happy, Lafayette.
Yeah, you just had a big old grin on your face.
Well, yeah, of course. Surely even you have some times when you can't help but smile. Right, Velvet?
I never thought about it. You know, I guess I do. Like when I managed to get the kitchen and the dishes sparkling and spotless.
Oh, I know that feeling. I feel that way when I get the bathtub scrubbed so clean that it's as good as new.
Definitely. Oh, and when I finish hanging a huge load of laundry out to dry on a beautiful sunny day.
Could you not compare this to doing chores?
The scouting vessel just contacted us. They say they found Terror Island.
Terror Island? What kind of place is that?
Aizen was talking about it earlier. It apparently moves around.
It's the damnedest thing. Legends say it's roamed the outer seas since time immemorial. They say it absorbs power from all of existence.
That sounds like it might be connected to Enominat.
We won't know anything more until we go there ourselves. First, we should join up with the crew at the docks in Isolde.
Come, sinner, and repent your wicked deeds.
Why are you whispering?
Because everyone else in your group has been nothing but trouble. Not a single one of them will truly repent. What kind of place do they think this holy sanctuary is?
I don't know what to tell you. You'll have to take it up with them.
I can't. You know what they're like, right? If I complain about it to them, they'll just beat the stuffing out of me.
I wish I could tell you that deep down they're all good people, but...
That's why you need to confess something.
What? Why me?
Please, I just want to hear a legitimate confession for once. If you don't hurry up, I'll put a curse on you.
Oh, all right. I'm so sorry for all the trouble that my companions have caused you, Father. Forgive me.
No, that's not going to work. I guess I'm not quite in the mood to forgive that yet.
Well, maybe you should repent for being such a petty, mean old priest!
I hear there's one really passionate Lady Teresa fan in Hellevies, but I'm not going to lose to a poser like him. Lady Teresa's true allure isn't in those frozen eyes. You can't say you understand her if that's all you see, but I do. Only I understand her true appeal. Do you want to know what it is?
Well, I don't think I really care.
Do you? Huh? Of course you do.
Okay, sure.
Well, if you insist, I'll tell you. Teresa's true allure is in that tinge of sadness hidden within her lovely face. Even when she's smiling, there's a touch of melancholy that never leaves her. It's like her heart is somewhere else, somewhere distant.
So where is it?
With her love, her true love, the true love she's yet to meet. How tragic! She suffers, lamenting the love she cannot find, yet doesn't realize that the very man she seeks is so near. That's why I watched over her so dearly. And then it happened. It was a day I'll never forget.
What happened?
She was off duty, frolicking in the waves by Maclear Beach. That alabaster skin, how pure she looked in her swimsuit.
This guy is really, really creepy.
Yeah, seriously creepy.
Hey, what's with that cold look?
I feel bad for Teresa. She had to protect creeps like this guy, too.
What cold, cold eyes you have.
Velvet, Eleanor, quickly, avert your gaze! If you keep looking at him with disgust and disdain, you'll only stimulate this perverted freak!
Come on, everyone. Let's go.
No, come back! Please! Scorn me! Despise me!
Yeah.